All right, guys, welcome to my favorite part of the competition, the Coach's Challenge. Any of you know, this is actually my favorite part of the competition. This is my favorite part of the season. Favorite part of this competition, my favorite part of the season.
I say it every season, my favorite part of the season is the Coach's Challenge. I love it because people don't realize what a total pressure cooker this place is for these guys. The Coach's Challenge is the day that they get to relax, they get to kick back and have fun.
Dana came back in the house tonight. With a bag in his hand, and we're all wondering what the hell's in that bag. I was hoping keys for all the semi-finalists to brand new car.
All right, guys, Ken and Tito are gonna play pool tonight.
You can't play pool.
Yes.
That's what Tito wanted to hear. Here's the way it's gonna work. It's the best of 2 out of 3 games.
And what's the winning get?
$10,000.
Immediately, Tito goes crazy because apparently Tito's very good at pool. Ken says he never plays pool. So I figured, you know, Tito's gonna kick his ass 2 games out of 3 and win the 10 grand.
You got this, Ken. Ready? Here we go. Tito. Shamrock breaks.
Touch it. No!
Unless... Ah! Yes! Oh! Oh!
He's a hustler! He's okay.
Hustled the shit out of us, man. That guy is a pool shark. Man, that guy can shoot pool.
Ken sandbagging his shit.
You know, I thought, well, maybe he just got a couple lucky shots. I go for a harder shot and I miss.
Hey, Paul, side pocket.
I was kind of worried when Ken won the first game. I mean, everybody can make mistakes. Give me a chance to run the table and I'll run the table. And then all of a sudden, the next game started, I break, I didn't make anything, and he ran the table. I was like, oh,
no!
Nice.
Ken was the shark, man. He had his pool hustler shirt on, his hair slicked back, the silver chain. He had it all, man. It was like right out of a movie.
Hey, ball, come on, fuck it.
I think I just got had.
Hello, the game.
Good game, man.
Yeah. Kill a kid.
You're gonna need the money anyway.
It's all right.
I'm gonna say.
Damn it.
Tito and Team Ortiz has been handing it to us. So to get in there in this challenge and actually turn the motivation a little bit in our favor, it was sweet for me. It was sweet for our team because they got something to cheer about. It was nice.
Hey, you guys, peace, man. Had a good time, man. Back to normal tomorrow. I still hate Tito's team.
I told BJ and Jens to meet me over at the house tonight, and they don't know it yet, but this is going to be the first time that they're going to go head-to-head in this competition.
And all of a sudden, Dana walks in with a DVD box or something. We're like, what's going on here?
You ready, coaches?
Yeah. You have a choice?
All right. The competition tonight is going to be ping pong.
Oh, dear God.
I told you.
You got pong? The winner.
I got no pong.
Oh, shit. Wins this.
Oh!
Are you shitting me?
Gents!
$10,000.
$10,000.
Dana proceeds to drop the biggest stack of money.
A block of cash like this.
Probably like 10 pounds.
10 G's.
Listen, the team that wins, everybody on your team wins $1,000. Well, these two are trying to make up their own fucking rules.
This sucks. This sucks. I cannot believe ping pong. Can't we just slam our head into the wall?
Listen. I don't want to hear any shit. You didn't know the fucking rule. Here it is. The game will be won by the player first scoring 11 points.
BJ looked hyped up and psyched and ready to go, and Jens looked like he already lost, you know, just like, I'm sorry, guys. Like, already apologizing to him. I was like, I'm sorry, guys.
We're doing the best of three, okay? So it's not just one game.
Yes, sir.
You got to win 2 out of 3. For the first time, BJ's in control now of his own destiny. You know, all he's got to do is win this ping pong game. He beats Jens Pulver, which is more important than anything, and all of his guys get $1,000 each.
That's a lot of money.
You ready, coaches?
Over. You choose. What do you want to do?
No, he gets first serve.
Oh.
Jens is all nervous, you know, paranoid nervous like he always is. I suck at ping pong. I don't know anything about ping pong. You can tell BJ sucks at ping pong too and it doesn't play. But BJ's like, you know, all amped up and crazy just to fucking compete. You know, so it's already fun and exciting.
Hold it like this.
I don't want to do it. I don't even want to be in the same house, BJ Penn. A disrespectful bitch, and I don't want to be around him. Until I fight him, that's it.
Right? So 0-0? Oh. 1 point, Team Penn. Oh. 1-1!
Still 1-1, right? That was the fault. 1-1.
God. It's about beating Jens too, you know. I want the 10 grand, but I don't want to lose to him at anything, you know.
Oh, shit.
Yeah! 6-3.
Some call it luck.
That was good.
BJ's doing well. And BJ wins the first game.
I call the boys.
Oh, what was that? Point!
All I remember is at some point I want to throw up. BJ's so tense. It's like he's getting shot at. I mean, we can't function.
They hit the...
What was that?
3-3, but it's my serve now. You know what, Jens wasn't bad. He had this kind of like a slicer shot, you know, and that's one thing I don't have in my arsenal is a shot like that, you know?
Yeah! Oh!
Yeah! You know what? His team helped them a lot. They'll be like, ooh, I'll just be like, oh, fucking guys.
This is insane. This is ping pong for fuck's sake.
So now game 3 starts. This is a good fucking game. What's the score?
3-1. A lot of money on this shit. Dana's waving it around like it's a big red banner. Look at the brick.
BJ. Now, we're playing ping pong, and BJ's fucking getting, like, freaking out. He's licking his lips. He's breathing heavy. He's pacing back and forth.
BJ's having a fucking nervous breakdown.
Long ball again. That fucking table was not long enough. Every time I seen it, it's like, can you lengthen it 10 feet, please?
10-9. Now you gotta win by 2, and it's my serve. No. 11-10. 7-11. Gets to the point where it's a tie game. It's 11-11.
Is everyone playing? Play it down.
Yeah! 12-11. Game point, team ball.
And all of a sudden, I just went, ah. And I just laid the ass whooping 3 points in a row.
Thank God BJ sucks at ping pong.
BJ, he is devastated.
He is not fucking happy at all.
We lost. Didn't mean anything. Who cares? We're gonna win the show, and then BJ's gonna beat Holder up in a fist fight, so who's the real winner?
It's irritating whenever you lose to somebody like Jens Pulver, just his type of character and person.
$1,000 in your pocket, that feels good, you know? I didn't even have to get a black eye for it, I mean.
Thanks, coach.
I think he's a ringer.
When he said ping pong, I was like, you gotta be fucking kidding.
I'm a pro ping pong player. I made 10 grand and was my debut match was on TV. I mean, shit, how can you go wrong with that? Rest of you bitches, watch out, I'm coming.
Ready? Let's go.
So for the coaches' challenge this season, we decided to take them down to the Red Rock bowling lanes. And these guys are gonna bowl a round of bowling to see who wins the money for their team. All right, guys. Obviously, the coach's challenge today is bowling. The coach that wins gets this.
Yeah. What is that?
A box of money.
How much is that, buddy?
There's 10 G's in here.
10 G's?
Okay. Winner gets 10 G's. The winning team gets 1,500 each. All right?
No pressure.
We'll get you guys shoes and get your fingers right for the balls, and then you guys got some time to warm up, okay?
These are good.
Yeah. I don't know if either one of them can bowl or not. Hughes lives in Illinois. What the f else would you do in Illinois?
How do you bowl? I mean,
you never.
I don't
bowl straight.
You know, there's people that can't bowl. There's people that can bowl. There's people that are good bowlers. And I'm like way down here. That I'm like the extreme opposite of a bowler. As we're warming up, you know, I like what I see on Matt's lane over there. Because, I mean, he's rolling like gutter balls.
I slipped on that one.
Just not doing well. So then I come up with the idea of, hey, the guys are only getting $1,500, you know, a piece. And I thought I could talk Dana into doubling their money.
Doubling the money?
Just for the winning team, not for the coaches.
Always the coach, aren't you?
Not good.
Why?
Because there's so many guys. Last year they got 1,000 each.
He's not buying. And then finally he looks at me, and he's watched me bowl, you know, and he knows I'm not really any good. He goes,
if Hughes can throw a strike right now, I'll double the fighter money.
You could what?
If Hughes can bowl a strike right
you
now,
actually gonna make I'll, me root for the guy?
I'll double okay. The fighter money.
Couldn't believe it. I rolled a strike.
And it made me think, this knows how to bowl. And he just worked me. You know what I mean? He was throwing the ball. And then as soon as I say, I'll double the money for everybody, boom, he throws a strike.
He's on the Illinois bowling team.
Three-time state champ, Illinois.
So now I'm convinced Hughes knows how to bowl, and he's Ken Shamrocking us right now. I think Matt Serra might be in trouble.
So the winning team gets 3,000 apiece. All right, let's go. Let's start this thing. Matt Serra's first.
My first one was a gutter ball. Not off to a great start. I heard my whole team kind of give a big,
Matt.
What? Guys, you stop.
Straight back.
I got you. I'll make it up with a strike right now.
Straight back, straight forward.
When Serra rolls it, the ball's going so slow, I think it's going to hit that first pin and stop.
There it is, Matty.
Or stop halfway down the lane, and he's going to have Drago and Longo out there going.
There it is, Matty.
Then here comes Hughes. As hard as he can, he throws that thing down there. And the ball's going 100 miles an hour. It hits the pins like it's going to shoot out the back of the wall. Only like 3 pins fall down. So this is going to be a good game. Both of them suck.
Just the second to last. Just the second to last.
I'm not the greatest bowler in the world, but I know a few techniques. I was like, you want to listen to me? I think you'll win. He's like, yeah. What do you got?
Straight up, straight down, baby. Wrist straight.
I was listening to Maddie. He was telling me about just keeping my arm a certain way. Don't let it waver. And all of a sudden, I'm bowling the game of my life.
Yeah, Maddie. Oh. Yeah, Matt. Oh. Yeah, Matt.
I was like his corner man, it was weird. And I was just trying to coach him through for the win.
We need more.
Oh. Yeah, man.
I had a narrow lead from the beginning and came down to that last frame.
Here we go, baby. Striker or spare and we win. There it is.
Here we go.
There it is, Maddie. Same exact throw you just did. Same exact.
Just like in MMA, I couldn't make any mistakes right now, you know?
Yeah, man, you got it, baby. Yeah!
I ended up getting a spare. It was pretty much the nail in the coffin for Hughes. Oh, God, I loved it. It was so great.
Maddie, take that box.
Oh, no, I shouldn't. Okay, all right.
Matt Sarah gets the box of 10 G's.
Oh, this
and you guys
suck.
Win $3,000. Oh,
hey, good corner man. Good job, Maddie. I can get gutter balls for the rest of my life. I could suck in every game of bowling from here to the day I die, but I had my day. I got my 10 G's, and more importantly, I made Matt Hughes very depressed, which I'm happy about.
Have a good night. Oh, yeah. Matt didn't stick around to shake hands, talk to anybody, have a couple of drinks, eat some pizza. Hughes was out the door and gone.
It didn't suck.
I don't think I'm a bad loser, but I don't like to lose. That's who I am. That's when God mixed his ingredients for me, he put, you know, a double helping of competitiveness.
I'm a happy little man, man. He's not a very good loser, which is a shame because when I beat his ass, he's gonna be upset about that too, so I don't know.
1, 2, 3,
shut up!
Yeah.
Thanks, guys. Couldn't have done without my team, guys.
Every season, to change it up a little, we have a coach's challenge where the coaches, you know, end up competing in something.
As we're walking into the Palms, Dana says, I hope you guys like to play cards. And me and Quentin say at the same time, damn, I suck at gambling too.
As soon as we come out of the elevator, we walk into the suite and there's a basketball half court in there. A couple of them started to realize that we were playing basketball.
I played basketball in high school like everybody, but I haven't shot a ball in at least 2 years.
I suck. I'm for real. I'm probably the worst basketball player on the planet. I'm an ass kicker. I can't play basketball. Kick ass.
So this season we decided to do Game of Horse. On this show, it's gonna be Ultimate Fighter. The winner of the Coach's Challenge wins the 10 grand. So the winning coach walks out of here with 10 G's tonight, okay? The winning team wins another 1,000, okay? You guys won 1,000 each. I said, I'll tell you what, guys, if Rampage can nail this three-pointer, I'll double the fighter money.
Oh, that's two grand.
And sure enough, he does it.
That was ugly as hell. So we were excited. Until Forrest started shooting, and he looked like Larry Bird in his prime.
I don't know if Forrest wanted that $10,000 or just wanted to beat Rampage in basketball, but he was dead serious about playing basketball. Ooh.
It didn't matter where Rampage stood, what he did, how he threw it.
Oh, that was close.
He wasn't making
One more. This is a game right here.
You know, I figured, end it with a knockout, right?
Good. Rampage is Rampage better hold on to that title.
Really, it don't matter if I lose to Forrest. He still got to see me in the octagon come July.
Every time we go into the Coach's Challenge, the fighters are always fired up for it because it's finally they get to see their coaches' asses on the line. And the coaches are always so nervous, you know? Am I gonna look like a dick on TV? And apparently Frank Mir, he's just convinced that this is gonna be a swimming event. And apparently he can't swim. He sinks to the bottom like a rock.
Yeah, sure.
While Nogueira, on the other hand, he heard about the Coach's Challenge, and from what I hear, he's been training in every sport there is. He's been golfing, skiing, he's been bowling, playing every sport there is to play out there, except the one that we're gonna do for the Coach's Challenge.
I always scared when I saw that, because I'm gonna tell you, everybody in Brazil was a good soccer. I was the only guy I didn't play. I never played soccer in my life because I was the worst player in Brazil. I'm the worst one.
Nogueira has never played soccer and is not good at soccer at all. When he pulled up and saw the soccer nets out there, he was like, oh, I'm gonna get humiliated in front of my whole country.
This is unfair, the Brazilian soccer. We couldn't have played a game of football. I've never played soccer.
Mir pulls up and says, this thing's biased. Of course he's played soccer, he's from Brazil. Listen, I'm from America and I've never played baseball. All right, this is the Coach's Challenge. Here's how it's gonna work. You put the ball in the white dot here. One of the guys stands in the goal. We'll flip the coin, somebody's gonna go first. If they score a goal or don't score a goal, then they go in the goal box. The other coach comes over and then kicks. First guy to 10 wins. Okay, now, the coach that wins the $10,000. Okay? The winning team wins $1,000 each.
Yes!
Okay, ready?
Yeah!
Do it. The name that pops up kicks first, okay? Mir kicks first.
I walked out of the car, I see the soccer game, I'm like, oh, I was just screwed. But I went out there, you know, stopped feeling sorry for myself and did the best I could at it, just realizing that Nogueira is nowhere near the same kind of athlete that I am.
Let's go, Hadou! Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! I never had a competition with Frank Mir, so I could see his face, how he was nervous. You know, that's good. It's kind of warm up before the fight.
Nogueira starts to pull ahead. We're going crazy cheering for him. And I'm getting a little louder than the rest. You know, yelling goal as loud as I can, just like the Mexican announcers. And it starts getting to Coach Mir.
Frank's walking back to his thing, and he's getting pissed.
At first, I was really upset with him as far as how disrespectful they are, but then I got to realize that a lot of them are losers. They're never going to be studs. It's just that's the way it is.
Nogueira's, like, diving and smacking balls out of the way. Frank's like, it's a little to the right. I'm not
Move it.
It's got to come right here. If it comes right here, I'll stop it. He's not f***ing up his hair to win this game, okay? Frank stopped a couple of balls. I think Frank starts to see that Nogueira's actually human and maybe he hasn't played soccer before. And it's neck and neck.
8-6.
We got now, look at that.
Oh!
Yes! 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 Yes!
9-6.
Yes! 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 We got it, baby. You got it. I'm gonna make 1,000 everybody pocket today, man. Okay?
Coach, put the pressure on him.
Try not to kick it to him, coach.
Oh!
I tried my best and we won. Very funny, my worst game in my life, you know, I won. I was more excited to win the $1,000 for each guy than win my $10,000.
Basically, it was a situation where I was never intended to win.
You lost to a Brazilian national sport. Why a Brazilian?
Actually, I feel kind of bad for him because the fact that I was able to score 6 points on him and he's played is kind of humiliating for him. Just kind of shows that, you know, I'm 200 times the athlete that he is. I can jump higher, run faster, move quicker, move longer. Anything we do that I know just as well as he does, I'm gonna crush him at.
We just pay our guys now.
I don't think so. I never played, but I guarantee I'll beat you.
You guys feel better now, right? You guaranteed it.
All right, guys, welcome. This is my favorite part of the competition. All the pressure's off you guys and on your coaches now. Obviously, today's competition is going to be tennis. The winning coach walks away with $10,000 in cash. Okay? The winning team, we'll give you $1,500 each.
I like your style, man.
Mama's gonna be happy.
Out of the feed. Normally in normal tennis, you have to serve inside one of the opposite boxes. That's not gonna be the case. You guys have to serve inside here. That's how little faith we have in you two. Okay? It's gonna be 6 games. And you have to be up by 2 games to win. Okay? Gentlemen.
Make some money, coach!
Anyone here play tennis? Anyone got some tips?
Allow me to slip into something more comfortable.
USA, Arthur. 1, 2, 3, USA!
Oh, God, listen to that. Round of applause, guys.
Neither of them strike me as guys who have played tennis or grew up playing tennis. So I always like that. I always think it's going to be interesting when you've got two guys that both suck at the same game.
Perhaps he needs some tea and crumpets. Bisping's gonna roll an ankle. Better start soon. Oh, Mike. Oh,
how about this? Your team shuts the up, and my team shuts the up.
No way.
Why? Because I'm sick of hearing that whining accent.
The whiny accent?
Go.
Breathe, Bisping, breathe.
Hey!
That's a point.
I thought he was gonna serve it inside the square.
No. Yeah. 15 points.
1 point.
15 love. Unlucky, inside unlucky, read the rules.
I thought you were talking about that.
Hey, 15 love.
Handicapping.
I'm touching the tennis, I like it.
I was out. Oh, stick to fighting, Mike. You suck at tennis.
Game, Anderson.
You won a game?
1-0?
Can you say ace?
Oh,
some of them serves Dan was putting in, they're straight out of the Serena Williams handbook, really. Finish it easy.
Anderson.
Yeah. Gets nervous yet?
We're stealing their spirit.
Was that free game?
We're stealing their spirit.
I've seen Band-Aids more tan than you, Michael Bisbee.
Yeah. He said some comment, actually. He said, oh, you're whiter than a Band-Aid, which I thought was pretty interesting coming from a black guy. I thought it was a little below the belt.
You are a white guy, and your legs are as white as a Band-Aid. At one point, Bisbee started fighting back, you know, and actually wins the game.
Yeah, it's game.
And then gets the next game close.
5-2.
One more, baby. One mother more.
I lost the tennis match. But who cares? You can stick your tennis up your ass. I'll see you on July the 11th. You know, we'll do it like men.
Hendo on three?
Yeah.
One, two, three, Hendo!
So we're getting ready for the coaches' challenge this season. We're doing it at the Palms.
Well, walk up on the sand?
Volleyball.
Beach volleyball between two guys who have never played beach volleyball.
He got a pride shirt on. He really messed with me today.
Never really played volleyball, but you know what I'm saying? I do watch volleyball sometimes when the women be wearing those little bit tight black volleyball shorts. And they butt cheeks be hanging out.
Teams are gonna be Rampage and Tiki, of course. And Rashad and Mike Van Arsdale.
Hey, man.
So the coaches are playing for $10,000 in cash.
Figure rain.
Each fighter will win $1,500 if their coach wins. All right?
No pressure.
You ready?
Hold up, team. Come on.
Tiki and Rampage? Dana, just give me the 10 G's right now, please. Please, just give me the 10 G's right now.
You ready? You guys ready?
No chemistry on that side.
So the game finally starts, and much to my surprise, these guys actually start playing some pretty good volleyball.
Man, right over there, coach.
Tip that.
Nice! Get it again, coach! Come on, get it again.
Who's that? Who's that?
One more now, let's go.
We won the first game. I'm like, yeah. For the first time, I saw Rashad frustrated. He was mad that he lost. I was so jazzed. I'm like, yeah, he ain't got no smart remarks. Look at his face.
You can run, but you can't
ready? Hide. All right, you guys ready? All right, let's do it.
Game two, it's a bit different. Dan started serving some nice stuff. And we are just clicking on all cylinders. We communicate really well. And we end up winning the second game. I'm so happy because now I know how to beat them. And I'm like, man, we got these dudes in a smash.
All right, guys, this game right here decides who wins the coach's challenge. Van Arsdale starts acting like he's Maverick from Top Gun. He's spinning the ball. And I got to be honest with you. It actually turns into a really good volleyball game. This is the winning point right here.
We won 10 G's. We won 10 G's. I'm doing a burnout in the middle of the floor, and Van's doing cartwheels on the other side. And we won $1,500 for each one of our fighters, man. And everybody is so happy.
Rampage is seriously pissed off, but actually shakes everybody's hand, including Rashad's, as painful as that must have been for him.
You know, I had a good time today. I had a real good time.
Too.
Hey, take your money, take your winnings. I don't need to touch it.
Come on, man.
Ain't my first time touching no 10 grand. I don't need to touch it.
You mad about this?
Ain't no money to me, homie.
Okay, that's cool.
10 grand ain't no money. I already spent 10 grand being here.
So. If you got so much money, how come you won't give your players no money? Hook them up.
Hey.
Give them $1,500 each. You got money.
Hey, look at
you got it like that, right?
Hey, I got it, homie. I can do whatever I got.
Because they should not be penalized.
Hey, I ask my team something. What y'all rather have, $1,500 or to see me knock it up? Out. Which one y'all want to see? Thank you.
That's funny.
You can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
Oh, this would be funny.
All right, guys, welcome to my favorite part of the competition, the Coach's Challenge. This season, it's dodgeball. The first team to win 3 games wins the Coach's Challenge. Now, obviously, you guys know.
Yeah.
I'll hold it for you.
The winning coach gets $10,000, okay? And everybody on his team gets $1,000, okay?
I'm just excited to hit Chuck with my balls. What's at stake in this game is nothing but 10 grand and bragging rights and pride, because I'd say we probably haven't had coaches who hate each other this much since Jens and BJ.
All right, this is game number one. First game starts off, and guys are picking guys off left and right.
Bro, Chuck's balls go.
Man, Chuck is a beast. He was gunning the ball, man. I swear there was smoke coming off that thing.
And then all of a sudden, it's just Tito and 3 of Chuck's guys in there.
Yeah, yeah, give me. Can I touch you?
And hit him, you're out.
Yeah, baby.
So obviously, 3-1 in dodgeball, they end up picking Tito off. Now we go into game 2.
You ready? Game 2!
Chuck's tired.
So it's 2-0. Chuck's beating Tito. And if Chuck can pull off this last game, it's a sweep. He sweeps Tito 3-0.
All right, you ready? You ready?
They're picking each other off left and right. Then at the end, it gets down to just Tito and Chuck.
Chuck and Tito.
Come on, Tito.
Remember that. Big jam, baby. As you know, we picked off Tito quite a bit because he couldn't move. He wasn't moving. He couldn't move his feet fast enough. So, you know, maybe the same problem he's got in the ring sometimes.
I've never seen so much emotion out of Chuck in my life. He's Mr. Dull, Mr. Non-Personality. But hey, I'd be happy too if I won 10 G's.
It's great. I came out on top again with Tito. I mean, he has the trouble beating me just about anyone.
Chuck, 10 G's.
Chuck's a competitor, man, and he's a smart guy, and you know, he outmaneuvered Tito so far coaching this season, too. And then he beats him 3-0 at dodgeball. So I'm sure Tito's getting pretty frustrated.
Good thing it's only dodgeball. Because the next time I'll be hitting Chuck will be with an elbow in the face or a punch in the face.
All right, Iceman, 0-3. 1, 2, 3.
Iceman!
Is the base bone? I'm an idiot. I didn't play this sport growing up, you know?
George doesn't know baseball, yes.
It's an American sport.
I was like, oh, this is going to be hard. I never played baseball in my life.
There's a pitching machine that will pitch to you. You're going to get 10 pitches. We're going to do 3 innings. If you get over the first fence here, you get 1 point. You get over the second fence, you get 3 points. And if you hit a home run, you get 6 points. At the end of 3 innings, the coach with the most points wins the $10,000 in cash.
Show me the money.
Okay? The winning team will also get $1,500 each. Okay? Team Koscheck hasn't done so well in this competition so far, so to come in and beat George St. Pierre, at least at the coach's challenge, would feel good for Josh.
Focus, Josh. You were born for this, Josh.
I haven't played baseball since probably about 13 years old, so a lot of anxiety about having rust.
You ready, Koscheck?
Get ready.
Yes.
Oh!
Wow. 1 point.
Hold on.
Seven.
Man, heckle his ass.
George, you can do nothing! George!
I was very excited because there's no way we're gonna let JSP win this competition.
Yeah! He's never swung a bat before?
No. He's never even held a bat before.
I'm not happy with your performance! George!
Savak gets the Best Heckler of the Year award.
I'm not happy with your performance!
If you know if that's what you're going for, if that's what you want to be the best at in the house, then you got it, buddy. You know, hey, you win this one.
How many?
Koscheck 7, St. Pierre 3.
It's your time!
Second inning, I was doing better. I hit the ball a couple of times.
Josh!
1 point.
That's one.
At the end of the second inning, George St. Pierre is starting to get the hang of this thing and get his rhythm. Oh, no, we got a game now. That's three.
You know, he hit a couple over, and I was real concerned with that.
All right, it's 16-10. Koscheck's winning. This is the last inning, and this is his last up at bat right here.
Nice, easy swings, Kos. Just connect.
You know, I said, all right, relax, get focused, and, you know, think back of playing baseball when you're a kid, you know?
Yeah! That's all the way, baby! Whoa! Yeah!
So Koscheck comes out in the third inning. He ends up getting his timing down and just starts crushing the ball out into the outfield.
I just kind of got in stride, got in that groove, and started cranking them out.
Stop! Yeah!
I'm very happy with your performance, Josh.
This is George's last up at bat.
For the third inning, I was kind of stressed, and I wasn't able to hit any ball.
Hold on! Team Koscheck, finally, these guys feel good about themselves. Not only did they win the coach's challenge, but every one of those guys all won some money.
Get used to this feeling.
You couldn't ask pick at worst sport for me, my friend.
In a baseball court, it's better than me, but in the octagon, I will prevail.
Man, next time we'll play hockey.
That's cool. Ice hockey? I play.
Ice hockey.
Yeah. George, what happened today here on this baseball field, get used to it.
One, two, three, cash money!
Because come December, you're going to have the same feeling. Swing and a miss again. Bap, I crack a home run. Lights out.
In 12 seasons of doing The Ultimate Fighter, we've done just about every sport there is out there, from ping pong to volleyball to baseball. And this year, we just thought football would be fun.
Wow.
All right, guys, welcome to Bishop Gorman High School's Fertitta Field. Bishop Gorman High School is the high school that myself and Lorenzo and our wives went to, so to be back at Gorman and doing the challenge is pretty cool. Obviously, today's challenge is football.
Yes.
I don't know how many people know this, but Brock Lesnar actually tried out for the Minnesota Vikings, and from what we hear, he did very well. So, poor Dos Santos.
I never play that.
When I blow the whistle, you'll begin. First, you're gonna do high knees through the ropes. Then you're gonna sidestep through the slalom here. Then you're gonna drive the sled for 15 yards. Then you're gonna kick a field goal from the 5-yard line.
Got this.
Then you're gonna throw a pass through the octagon down there. Then you're gonna catch a pass and run it all the way back 100 yards to the other end zone. The first coach to make it back to the end zone wins. This is more of an agility skills test, and both guys are incredible athletes, so I think this thing is a lot more fair than it looks on the surface. And the first coach to make it through gets $10,000. And his team gets $1,500 each.
$10,000, that's very good, huh? I think we both sucked. He just got luckier than I did.
I want some money. The guys want some money too. I was thinking a lot. The Tim Lesnar deserves something too. So I take 100 for each guy, and I gave 500 bucks for each coach. Yeah, I split the money. Everybody got paid except for Brock. Yeah, he doesn't deserve. He lost.
Come on, boy. Come on, boy.
My initial thoughts when I walk in and I see an air hockey table, I was like, oh, God, here we go. I do play air hockey a little bit with my kids. I'm not, like, taking it seriously, so I let them win. I've never played air hockey seriously in my life. This isn't my cup of tea, let's put it that way.
I thought for sure we were going to be up here playing cricket.
The last time I played air hockey was probably fourth grade. I immediately thought, damn it, I should have trained for this.
It's air hockey, let's not get too technical.
Team Mayhem gets possession of the puck first. He gets to pick which side he wants to play on. It's the best out of five. So the first coach to win three games wins the coach's challenge. And one game is 7 points.
Let's do it.
Get it?
I know I say this all the time, but I love the coach's challenge. It's my favorite part of the season.
Team Mayhem has possession of the puck.
This thing is such a pressure cooker for all the fighters, man. These guys are here, they're under pressure all the time. It's the one day that they actually get to show up and relax and have fun and let their coaches take all the pressure. I think everybody has played air hockey at least once. You don't have to have grown up in a country where you played baseball or American football or soccer or whatever, but to be honest with you, they both suck.
I'm just warming up.
I'm getting smashed right now. Are you kidding me?
The next point wins for Bisbing.
That's pressure. Oh, let's go. Oh.
Yeah. And he's trying to cheat.
Hey, hey, hey. I up. You got a point.
This motherfucker's been training.
I think he was doing a little pool hustle on me. He's acting like he'd never played it, but the minute he got that mallet on his hand, he looked like a damn professional.
1-0.
Is it strong? I'm just killing it, basically. I'm a natural. I think I might actually give up the UFC and be a professional air hockey player because I couldn't lose. Well done. I scored an own goal. The only points that Miller is scoring are my own goals.
The next point wins for Bisbing.
The first game was an absolute blowout. Bisbing wins 7-1. The second game is 7-4. So it looks like Bisbing's going to sweep him.
It's okay. It's just a game. It's just $10,000.
Now, by the third game, Bisbing is just talking the entire game.
You got it, Jason. You're doing fantastic. After this, I want lessons off you.
It's like he's more focused on talking to Mayhem than winning the game, and I'm thinking he's probably going to blow this.
I didn't even hit it. I started to kind of figure it out a little bit, but that was a damn stressful situation, honestly.
Six to four.
ends up winning game 4, 7-4, and wins the coach's challenge. One minute you're celebrating, I'm the king of the world. And then you're laying on your ass looking like a jackass in front of millions of people on television. He landed hard on his back, man. And I don't give a what he says. He is sore as hell today. I guarantee it.
Boys, have I let you down yet? Have I? The 10,000 took the sting out of the fall. I think my elbow's a little sore, but other than that, I live to tell the tale.
I was bummed for my fighters, you know? They could use that money a whole hell of a lot more than I could. And I was pretty sore to let them down like that. But the real coach's challenge is on December 3rd. And that is where I smash Bisping's face.
All right, guys, welcome to the Coach's Challenge. This is my favorite part of this competition. It's the day when you, the fighters, get to relax, kick back, and all the pressure is on your coaches.
Yeah. Wow. That's all you could say, wow.
As you guys know, the winning coach wins $10,000 in cash. But for the first season ever, Tap Out matched it for another $10,000 in cash. $20,000 in cash to the winning coach, and the winning team gets $1,500 each.
There's a lot at stake here. First and foremost, my guys' morale, $1,500 apiece, and then 20 G's in my pocket, so pretty pumped on that.
Good luck, guys. Here we go. Let's do this.
There you go, Dominic.
As soon as the competition starts, Dominic flies through the rope. He gets right to the top of the rope quick. Uriah looks like he's having a little bit of trouble with it.
Dom's gonna kill him because, you know, that's all people do in Tucson is shoot at each other.
Dominic was ahead of me by a little bit, and I missed my first couple shots with the pistol.
The pistol's got 5 targets set up. I hit almost all my targets on the first try. Tire flip's a big, heavy tractor tire. You gotta flip it a few times. The hard part about this is you're getting your heart rate up, your adrenaline's at a high because you're competing and you're doing things that you never practiced, so you're nervous.
He beat me on the tire flip, and I was just behind him, enough to keep it competitive. Fire! The next station was the dummy carry, just trying to make up some ground. I was still behind. Dominic was doing pretty good on the course. Go, Uriah!
The next weapon is a fully automatic saw. And I hit the first one right off the bat. Second one, man, I couldn't hit it.
The Marines were telling me that's the hardest one. Those jugs.
The thing's just like laughing at me in the distance. Like, ha ha ha, you can't hit me. I'm just like, grr.
Hey, Uriah catches up to him. And he bangs out both the jugs before Cruz gets his last jug.
All of a sudden, Faber's in the lead, you know, and we're kind of like, man, it's not going well anymore.
got to the ammunition carry, and I had a little bit of a head start there because I caught up, and I was thinking, what would James Bond do? He'd chill out. The grenade launcher, you have to just be composed, breathe, and see where you're missing and adjust. Saw that thing explode and felt like I was in war, man. Felt like I was getting close to winning the battle. Got to the grenade launcher and I hit it. Now I caught up. I'm in the zone. I'm focused. I'm going to win. There's no other option. That last explosion was just such a weight off my shoulders. It could have been any closer, and I'm pissed, naturally.
It basically panned out the way the season panned out. Dominic started off fast, and he was ahead, and then Uriah came back and got the victory.
Here's the other one.
Getting that 20 G's from Dana was awesome. My team was just pumped, man. They all got some money out of the deal.
Show me the money!
Feels awesome to get the better of Dominic. Got to rub it in his face a little bit.
Hey, you want to touch it? This could have been yours. This is heavy. Dom, you want to carry this back to my car?
It sucked losing, but I feel like I lost the battle on the coach's challenge. But I'm not going to lose the war July 7th.
That was close.
Keep that momentum going, baby.
That was good stuff. Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
Welcome to Bishop Gorman's Victor Park for my favorite part of the season, the Coach's Challenge. Today's challenge will be track and field. The coaches will compete in a series of five track and field events. The winning coach wins $10,000, $20,000 this season. Woo! 46-3. Second throw, 40 for Royce. All right, Shane Carwin wins the first challenge and the 3-meter advantage. 120 and 9 inches. Shane Carwin wins this event. 95 feet for Shane Carwin's second throw. Royce's second throw, 80 feet, 6 inches. Shane Carwin wins the event. Foot 8 inches for Shane Carwin's second jump. Shane Carwin wins the long jump.
Let's go!
At the end of the race, you know, I broke him. He quit. I crossed the line, finished ecstatic. My team's happy.
You know what? He can beat me in track and field. He can beat me in bumper carts, but he's not going to beat me in MMA.
This whole competition is a pressure cooker for these guys. Every day they're stressed out, they're training, they're beating their body up. This is the day that they really get to relax and have some fun. They're cheering on their coaches. All right, guys, welcome to Dig This and the Coaches Challenge, which is my favorite part of the season. This is the day that all the pressure is on the coaches and you guys get to kick back and relax. So obviously what's gonna happen here today is you guys are gonna compete in three different competitions while driving excavators. The winning coach will get $10,000,
and each fighter on the winning team gets $1,500. You will have to scoop up a basketball off the cone and drop it into the large tire. The first one to do that wins the competition, the $10,000, and the $1,500 for each one of your fighters. Good luck, guys.
I've never been on one of these, but my father-in-law owns an excavation company, and had I known what this was, I would have given him a call and got at least a little bit of tips verbally, but no, this is a new experience.
Listen, I come to win. That's it. You know, you want to win, put bones in. So we got it, baby. We're going to get it done.
Yeah, babe. Oh, yeah, baby.
Oh, yeah. Usually every coach's challenge is some type of sports-related, competition. I think this is the first time we've ever done anything like this. It's going to be pretty cool.
All right. You guys ready to go?
Yep.
On your marks. Get set. Go.
He's done this before.
Yeah.
There's no doubt. When we first came out the gate, John was scooping right up and dumping dirt in there.
Yeah, baby.
And then all of a sudden, John started to fall apart and Chael started to get the hang of it.
Chael got bigger scoops of dirt and he filled up his bucket first, or his dumpster first.
Chael must be done.
Now, Chael, you're going to go and reach over those tires.
Chael fills his dumpster up first and moves on to the tire stacking. He's ripping tires back and forth, and I had the headphones on so I could hear him, and Chael's talking smack to John the whole time.
Hey, John, you know they said go, right? You can start the competition.
Is John's headphone working? Somebody let him know that we've begun the competition.
Oh, yeah, you're all right, Chael.
Got right over there?
All right, brother.
Just want to help out.
Slow and steady wins the race. It looked real ugly for our team at one point. Then we moved to the tires. Chael was also winning at that at the beginning because he did good in the dumpsters. Chael had two tires already over there while I was still on one side dealing with one tire.
No, John, the idea is to pick the tire up. So you want to
Chael.
I'm trying to help. See, if you'll pick the tire up, then you can move it.
Yeah, all right.
The tire thing went really well. I got a really good feel for the thumb. I was moving the tires. I couldn't stack the suckers up. You know, when you release it, you got a balance issue now. It's not just put it in a certain place. And I was so frustrated thinking, I don't know why I can't get this.
Son of a bitch.
So it's like starting over from scratch.
John, give me an update. I can't see over there. Well, I'm doing all right, Chael.
Chael's having trouble stacking the pyramid, and John comes back. All of a sudden, his tires were spread apart just enough for that thing to maybe balance on there if he was good enough to do it.
Yeah!
And he comes back and literally sets that thing right on top, builds the pyramid, shoots down, and he's gonna win the competition.
Bradley Jones bringing it on home. There you go. Chael started off winning, but we caught up on that third tire with precision and just, you know, being patient and calm and relaxed.
Let's go, big man. Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Came to the basketball. Part of the competition where we pretty much had to pick up a basketball with this million-pound machine.
This is tougher than it looks. This is going to be...
Push it quick.
Oh, he got it! Holy
oh, my God. Sorry, guys.
He scoops the basketball out. He's got it right over the tire. The ball rolls out. Oh, my God. That was so close. So Chael gets down there, scoops up his ball.
Oh, there it is. Here we go.
Oh, man! Chael wins the coach's challenge. He wins the $10,000, and his whole team wins $1,500 each.
Chael has won the bowling tournament. He has won the coach's challenge.
But we're here to win the fights, you know, so came up short. But I may be down, but I'm not out.
One more for the bad guys! When I won and the thing went in and I saw the guys celebrating, that was pretty cool, you know. I've been cheering these guys on ever since we got here. I've been coaching them and getting them ready to go. And the roles were reversed today, which is kind of what the fun part in the spirit of competition that the coach's challenge is all about.
Dude, that's way up there.
And then when we got in and we seen the rock climbing walls, I just thought to myself, Ronda's got this.
All right, guys, welcome to the Mandalay Bay Event Center. We are here for the Coach's Challenge, which is my favorite part of the season. It's where you, the fighters, get to kick back, relax, and all the pressure is on the coaches. Obviously, today is rock climbing, okay? Yeah. Each side of this wall are mirror images of each other. They're the same exact climb. The first coach to reach it to the top and ring that bell in the center wins $10,000.
Oh my god.
And everybody on their team gets $1,500 each.
Yes. That's what I'm talking about.
So you guys will sit back there, you relax. There's some Miller Lite, there's some NOS energy drinks. You guys, no pressure on you today. All the pressure is on the coaches. Cheer them on. Have a good time. Good luck, you guys.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It's a 50-foot rock climbing wall, which actually has an inverted incline at the top. And I'm told this is similar to the Olympic rock climbing courses.
It's called the double back, so this will not slip on you at all.
Okay.
I've always heard from rock climbers, you gotta kind of pace yourself in order to not burn your grip out, because once you lose your grip, you basically can't hang onto the wall. So I'm just gonna try to keep all that in mind, use my legs to push me up, and keep a steady pace.
When you have two coaches and you do a coach's challenge and the coaches hate each other, it's just that much worse. You do not want to lose, you know? It's always hard for the coaches that lose, especially in front of their team. All right, on your mark, get set, go!
It was close. I mean, started off good, taking it nice, slow and steady, and then all of a sudden, I think Ronda looked over and saw Misha neck and neck with her and said, hell no. So she just turned on the afterburners and just ripped up that wall.
It was a real tight race. They were both neck and neck, and at the very end, Ronda got a couple feet on her and rang the bell first and flipped her off on the way down, so it was pretty funny.
So classy. At least I'm upfront about it.
It's real. The rivalry is real. I know it's going to be a good fight when they fight again. Definitely, there's a lot of animosity built up. And I think this time, Misha has got to try and control her emotions and not let herself get angry and fight with anger. Instead, she's got to use her head.
Congratulations. Woo! Thank you. It's unfortunate, you know, I feel like I kind of let my team down, but outside of that, you know, I really had fun with the challenge.
Wow.
Thank you, Dana.
You're welcome.
All for you guys.
To be able to help out my team, it's just, it touches me more than anything else. Their gain is more than my personal gain. And I just like Misha being in the habit of always getting beaten by me, so. It's cool.
Good thing we tapered your training off.
off down.
That's what it is, man. Damn, you kayak?
Oh, that's cool. No.
Yeah,
no.
You do, bro.
No,
you go
no,
to your buddy's
real.
House on a kayak.
We're supposed to do the coach's challenge today. I show up, and I see two kayaks.
How he picked water sports? This dude visits his buddy down the street on a kayak.
Frankie was already complaining that, you know, you give him a water sport. You know, this guy's from Hawaii, and I understand where he's coming from. It's going to be tough for him, but he's a good athlete. He'll be fine.
Gentlemen, welcome to the Coach's Challenge. This is my favorite part of the season. This is when you guys get to kick back, relax, no pressure on you. All the pressure is on your coaches. So here's how it's going to work. Starting line is right here. You guys are going to go out through this first buoy, stay outside the buoys all the way around, come back this way, through the bridge, and there'll be a finish line right here. Any questions? No? All right.
So, get that Frankie cardio!
The winning coach wins $10,000 in cash. And everybody on their team gets $1,500 each. You guys ready? Let's do it. All right.
Frankie's ultra competitive. Even though BJ lives in Hawaii and owns a kayak, Team Red's gonna win this like we're gonna win everything else.
You guys ready?
Yes, sir.
Ready? Set.
I'm trying to turn back. Right at the beginning, kind of get jammed up at the first buoy. After that, Frankie takes off. He's leading it. I told myself, don't panic. Stay with this.
They are neck and neck, man.
Going through the first couple of the zigzags, I was doing all right. And we got to the one buoy, we got to make a complete circle, and I couldn't get the damn thing to turn around. And by the time I got back on track, BJ had a pretty good lead on me. I thought Frankie was gonna turn a little better, but you know what? Honestly, I didn't care if Frankie was in between. I was just gonna smash right through to get my angle.
I have a feeling it does have something to do with who's staying, you know, sharpest on the turns, and you know, and it. BJ was definitely pulling away on the turns. So.
This is not my ass since it's got to Hawaii! Come on!
Are your arms smoked?
Hey! This is how my ancestors got to Hawaii. Don't feel bad. All I knew was, don't look back. I see all my guys cheering. I see his guys not cheering. It made me just go harder because I knew that Frankie was behind. Hats off to Frankie. Always a great competitor. And I'm glad we won today.
There you go.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Frankie. So, guys, this is without a doubt my favorite part of the season, the Coach's Challenge. The winning coach wins $10,000 cash, and the winning coach's team win $1,500 each.
Ooh.
Good luck, you guys. Welcome to the Coach's Challenge.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Coach's Challenge. Coaches, you'll be tested on your knowledge of the UFC with three rounds of trivia.
Anthony's had a bad knee. He's coming off knee surgery. So instead this season, we did UFC trivia. Usually every season is a physical challenge. They usually go head-to-head in some type of physical competition. This is the first season ever that we haven't done physical competition. We did trivia.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ultimate Fighter contestants and coaches, it's time! There will be three rounds at a sudden victory round. So here we go. Round one, the category is the Ultimate Fighter. Each question is worth 100 points. First question. In the history of the Ultimate Fighter, there have been 10 fighters who have both competed and coached the show. Name two of them. Gil.
Rashad Evans. Forrest Griffin.
Correct.
When I found out that the Coach's Challenge was a game show, I was like, wah, 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 wah. I was not confident in Anthony at all. Because he was saying, oh, I don't really watch UFC. I don't really watch my opponents.
What fighter has won a UFC title but did not win his season of The Ultimate Fighter?
Forrest Griffin? Forrest Griffin?
Incorrect.
Use your brain, Anthony. Use your brain. It's a good thing he's, you know, athletic and all.
Gil, ahead with 400 points. Anthony, running up backwards with zero. Now we're going to go on to round two. Each question is worth 200 points. It's still anybody's game, folks. UFC history.
Right.
In what year was the first UFC event held? Anthony.
93.
Correct.
UFC history was probably Anthony's best part of the competition.
Anthony.
GSP.
Correct.
He had a lot more answers in the second round. At one point, they were tied.
600 points each. Round three. Well, here we go. The category is famous finishes. Each question now is worth 300 points. First question. Underdog Forrest Griffin beat Mauricio Shogun Hua at UFC 76 in the third round by what?
RNC.
Gil.
Rear-naked choke.
Correct. UFC 34. Matt Hughes takes the world welterweight title from Carlos Newton of the very first round by what?
Gil. Slammed him with the triangle.
Correct. Yes.
I don't think there was ever a point where Gil was behind. And he just blew it out of the water in the last round.
Who needed only 6 seconds to record the fastest KO in UFC history?
Dwayne Bang Ludwig.
Correct. Gil, you're ahead with 1,800 points. Anthony, you've got 900 points. It's still anybody's game. Why? Because now is sudden victory.
What?
Yeah. Please, take this moment right now, write down your wager. Here we go. Anderson Silva is known as one of the greatest champions in UFC history. How many successful title defenses does he have? Here we go. Anthony, you're up first. What is your answer?
Nine.
Incorrect. What was your wager?
All of it.
Okay, Anthony, you have zero now. Gil, what is your answer?
Also nine.
Incorrect. What did you wager?
None of it.
Oh. And we have a winner. The winner of the new Coaches Challenge champion is Gilbert El Nino Melendez.
And I'm taking the bout. We're both on the same page right there. Anderson Silva has 10. I said 9. Anthony said 9. I wagered 0. He wagered all of it. So, you know, it worked out. I won.
Congratulations, Gilbert. You win $10,000 in cash. And each of your fighters have each won $1,500.
I was excited. That's kind of fun. We don't need to get injured for this fight. We need to fight I want to beat him in the octagon, but I want to beat him at everything as well. The coach's challenge, the matchups, and you know, this is the biggest stage, and I'm here and I get a second chance to fight for the title against Anthony Pettis, and you know, this is something I've been working for my whole life.
Gil's been losing all season. It took him to the last fight to even get a win, so I think that their spirits are a little up.
But at the same time, that's not gonna stop me from whooping his ass.
Get used to losing, Gil, because my team ain't losing and I ain't losing.
So we're going somewhere. It's kind of a mystery right now to do the coaches challenge, so I have no idea what it is. I'm told it took a lot of preparation to get it together, so I'm just ready for anything.
Y'all ready for this?
He said go, 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 so we just went. I thought we were going.
He's already all nervous, this guy. Settle down, bud. It's gonna be all right. Not quite.
Yeah.
I think I might have Betty Chad out here somewhere. I think I might have dumped Chad's buddy out here somewhere. And I'm just, this looks familiar out here.
Here it comes. Here it comes.
Gentlemen, welcome to the Coach's Challenge. This is my favorite part of the season. No pressure on you. All the pressure is on the coaches. They have to perform. You kick back and relax today. Today's Coach's Challenge will be the airdrop. Both coaches will go up in a helicopter. You will take 5 watermelons. You will drop them onto the target. There are points for each section of the target you hit. The bullseye is 100 points. At the end of the airdrop, after 5 watermelons, the coaches with the most points win the coaches challenge. They get $10,000 for themselves and $1,500 for each one of their team members. Gentlemen, good luck today.
Dana flies in on a brand new chopper. Ariane has my money in a briefcase the way I like my money. I only accept money in briefcases. It's a good experience coming out here, seeing all these choppers and cameras, and I would have liked a bit more physical, you know what I mean? A bit more athleticism, explosiveness, because he would have been buried in the desert if that was the case. But I still feel my accuracy is too precise, even with watermelon.
You're done, son.
Yeah,
all right. You're done.
I'm gonna hit the target.
It's down.
Let him go first.
All right.
This guy's nervous. Don't be nervous. Wake up your mind!
It's mind games, baby.
You're playing mind games with yourself.
Get it, baby! Let's do this!
Sick.
Get up!
I missed.
So going into the last round, Uriah's winning 85-70. So this is the last shot, which will literally determine who's gonna win the coach's challenge. In on his last shot and hits the bullseye, which is 100 points. So now it's 185-70, no matter what Connor does. Even if Connor hits the bullseye, he's done. It's game over. Uriah wins.
The bullseye. What's that? That was the bullseye. What's that? Woo! Game over! Game over, baby! You gotta adapt to this! The same as being a champion.
The challenge. I feel sick as a dog over that, yeah? But what can you do? It was a good experience. I enjoyed it. Yeah. I don't like losing. Congratulations to the little buff-faced twerp.
Don't be shy, Americans. Let's go get your coach, boys.
Oh man, I feel great winning that challenge. My guys were so pumped up, got my coaches some extra cash, and man, I could tell Connor was very bothered by the whole situation, and that felt good too.
Oh my God, this is yours, my money, I'm sorry.
You knew how we felt.
Yeah, baby, that's a little foreshadowing.
I'm impressed.
This is awesome.
What's up, everybody? Good afternoon. If any of you know, this is actually my favorite part of the competition, the coaches challenge. It's the time that all the pressure is on the coaches and not on you. You guys get to kick back, relax, and have fun today. So I would have to say that this is the craziest coaches challenge that we have ever done.
I can't see, man.
Obviously, behind me here are two massive dunk tanks. So how this is gonna work, both coaches will stand up there. You guys are gonna have an air rifle that shoots tennis balls out into that target. Whichever coach goes first will stand at the railing and shoot at the target while the other coach is in position to get dunked. If you hit the 20, it's an automatic dunk. The first coach to 100 points wins the competition. So each coach can be dunked up to 5 times. And believe me when I tell you, you do not want to get dunked. These two excavators dumped 90 bags of ice in that water. That water is freezing cold. The winning coach gets $10,000 in cash, and each part of the team gets $1,500 each. You ready? Good luck, you guys.
We don't have dunk tanks in Poland, you know, but I used to do climbing before I start with martial arts, so I'm not afraid to be really high, you know?
I'm not scared of height, but I'm scared of water, and if she dunked me, I was gonna go in the water.
All right, guys, I'm gonna flip the coin to see who shoots first and who gets dunked first. Joanna, Claudia. Yeah. Claudia wins the coin toss. Do you want to shoot first or dunk first?
Shoot first.
Shoot first.
You want to shoot first?
Yes.
All right. You're going to dunk first.
I wasn't worried about the money. I just wanted to beat Joanna so bad. I wanted to dunk her inside that water so bad.
Be careful, Claudia. Don't
kill yourself, huh? You must fight soon. Don't kill yourself. Come on, don't do this.
You ready? Fire away! Hey! 10 points.
Close.
Sayonara, biatch. I will be back. So cold. Whose idea was this?
All right, Joanna, it's your shot. Can't get any more center for that one. All right, 30 to 20. You're up, Claudia, fire away. Claudia, you have 80. A bullseye wins you the game. Yeah. Fire away.
Yeah. Finish it.
For the game.
How was your shower? Was good? Cold enough?
Congratulations, you win the $10,000. Your team wins $1,500 each. Yay! Now you have the opportunity to win another $5,000, and your team wins another $500. I'm gonna go up there. You have 3 shots to dunk me, and you'll win $15,000.
I'm gonna dunk the boss. That's exciting.
The water don't bother me. I don't like heights.
He went up there. He was very scared.
All right?
No, I'm not all right.
Standing right there.
Right in the square?
Yeah.
Oh.
You gotta stand in the square though.
Like this?
Yep.
I don't know if I can do this.
I felt sorry for him.
Ah! This thing's shaking like a
It's easy. Relax.
I'm scared.
Breathe.
Breathe. Relax. It's easy.
When I look at him, he was very scared. And that was exciting to me, you know?
It's 5,000 if you hit the dunk. I'll give you 10,000 if you miss.
You can't tell probably on TV, but that thing was high. This wasn't like the dunk tank you see at the fair. This thing is high, and the things we're standing on were flimsy as hell. If you don't like heights, that is not a good feeling up there.
Don't look at me.
Hold on. The girl's been doing it all day, and I'm the biggest pussy here. I think I'm gonna faint.
Are you ready?
No, I'm not ready, but what the am I gonna do? Are you gonna send a machine to put me back down? No, I mean.
Three, two, one, go!
This is the craziest challenge we've ever done, you know? We've done some fun stuff and things that play out really well. This was without a doubt taking two of the best fighters in the world champion and the number one contender, putting them on a flimsy 22-foot platform and dropping them at the 12 feet of freezing cold water is definitely the craziest one we've ever done. All right, Team Claudia, babe, you get $15,000.
Oh, that's bad. Thank you.
You guys get $2,000. Congrats.
I was like kind of angry because it was just a stupid competition. The final round is going to be July 8th and I'm gonna make sure that I'm gonna win this. Maybe I'm not the best sniper, but I know how to shoot with my punches and I'm gonna make sure that I'm gonna knock her out.
We pull up to the coach's challenge. This is kept a secret, so we have no idea what it's gonna be. I know that we could do 10 things and I'd be better than him, so I feel pretty good going in. Then it becomes real when we pull up to Topgolf and I'm like, golfing is so hard. You're just like, I have to actually be good at golf. What if he's good at golf?
Man, I don't know anything about golf. Nothing. I don't know what, I mean, what they call clubs. I was calling them sticks. Once I knew we were going to golf, I was like, man, I was hoping this guy was worse than me.
Guys, welcome to Top Golf, and today is the coach's challenge.
Yeah.
I love this day because no pressure is on you. All the pressure is on the coaches.
Yeah.
So let me walk through how this is going to work. So each coach is gonna have a turn to hit 20 balls, okay? The targets are divided into rings out there. The closer the ball is to the center of the target, the more points you get. Also, the farther away the target, the higher the score. The highest score is a hole in one at the center of the farthest target. That will get you 50 points. If you hit the inner rings of the close targets or hit anywhere on the far targets, the points you earn on your next shot will be double. So, in theory, you could score 100 points with one shot. The coach who gets the most points at the end of 20 balls wins $10,000 and a trophy.
We want that trophy.
And the winning coach's team gets $1,500 each. Cejudo, Benavidez. I'm gonna flip the coin, and the winning coach gets to pick whether he wants to go first or second. Yeah. Okay? Oh! Benavidez.
I'll go second.
Second? Yeah. All right. Fighters, grab some food, grab a drink, sit back, relax, and let's get the coach a challenge going. Yeah.
Yeah.
nice and smooth. Slow on the way back.
I do the same thing, bro.
First swing, first time on the tee, I wasn't even messing around. I tried to hit the ball, and I missed it. And I really started laughing. And I was like, ah, okay, man, maybe it's just, maybe I'm just got the jitter.
It's gonna be a long day, boys.
Cejudo goes up, he just whiffs it straight, doesn't even, just hits air. No ball, no grass, no nothing. I felt pretty good. I felt like this was a good thing for us.
At zero.
Where is it?
At zero. I hit the far right. Far right. Zero. 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 Zero.
One more leg.
That's me.
It's
early on, round two starts. I whack the ball and I get 4 points. I'm officially in the lead. Team Cejudo, baby.
Three points. So 6-4. After two rounds, Benavidez leads 6-4. Not exactly a roaring start, but hey, these guys are fighters, not golfers.
Come on, playboy.
Oh, that's off. No points.
Then, for the next several rounds, things got even worse. They didn't score any points. Then on his fifth shot, Benavidez breaks the drought and gets a 7. He also hit the inner ring, so that means his next score will be double. 13-4. Zero. Zero.
Joe's just, he's on fire. I think somebody gave him a jalapeno. He was, he was able to launch that ball like nobody's business.
Zero.
Get money.
It didn't go in.
I'm sorry, guys.
Cejudo was getting smoked. He kept getting zeros, and Benavidez just kept scoring doubles. After 14 rounds, the score was 100-8.
See how disgusted it looked by me? Look at him.
He's still in it. He can still win this. With bonuses and bullseyes, he can still win.
Oh, that's far right again.
That's it.
Okay. 20 points. The next one would be double. So just when I start to think that Cejudo's almost out of it, he hits the inner ring and gets 20 points. Which also means his next shot is going to be double. So if he can continue getting doubles or even hit a hole in one, he could possibly catch up.
That's in there. Yeah.
26. 28, Benavidez.
So it seems like Cejudo is going to mount some type of comeback, and then boom, Benavidez hits a great shot, scores double points, and by the start of round 19, the score is Benavidez 144, Cejudo 28. Now it's Cejudo's turn, and he needs to hit a hole-in-one or this game is over.
Ah! Volkswagen!
Zero?
Oh my lord. Good
choice. Get money!
Hey, Team Benavidez wins $1,500!
I hate to lose, but I'm not gonna freaking beat myself over for something that I don't know. But something that I do know, like this, like the cage, that's my game. It's not going to be Top Golf. It's not going to be me hitting a ball and trying to get a 50-point target. It's going to be me putting my leather in his face.
Give him the trophy. And the trophy!
Thank you.
I just felt the positive energy of the team and just saw him crumbling. And, of course, that, you know, feeds me even more. And just kept, you know, doing good out there. And ended up walking away with the trophy, the money, and some money for my team, which made me, you know, happiest.
That's tetherball with a balance beam. What the heck?
Gentlemen, welcome to the Coach's Challenge. This is my favorite part of the season.
Yeah!
This is the day that there is zero pressure on you and all the pressure is on your coaches.
Yeah.
As you can see, it's freezing out here today.
Perfect day.
So we have set up water tetherball for your coaches. To make it even more fun, it's on a balance beam. The way that this is gonna work is you will stand on the balance beam, you will hit the ball. If you fall in, you have to jump right back up onto the balance beam before your opponent wins the game.
Oh.
It's the first to 10 games, which means this could go up to like 19 games of tetherball. Winning coach wins $10,000, and everybody on his team wins
$1,500. Yeah!
Everybody ready?
Yeah!
Good luck, coaches.
Champ is here! The champ is here!
Yeah, baby!
If you would have told me that I could win $10,000 playing playing tetherball as a kid, I would have played a lot more of it, you know? So, a little nervous, man.
Look at that ninja.
Ninja.
I played tetherball like maybe once or twice, you know, in second grade, so it's been a while. I was looking forward for the challenge. I can't wait to go out there and, you know, get this win for our team.
That was
we
quick.
Win, that's it. Yeah. It's over. Oh,
yeah. Good thing you took the boat out.
Sure enough, I fall in the water before the game even starts. So, horrible start to this game.
Ready?
Keep up the good work, TJ.
Go.
In the head.
Coach, here it comes.
Got the first score. You know, my team's all pumped up and they're, you know, it's energizing me. It's, you know, keeping me pumped up so I'm not freezing in this wetsuit.
That's game.
It was even tougher than I could even imagine.
That's 2-0, Garbrandt.
Yeah.
Dillashaw serves.
I felt like I started figuring out how to play the game. You know, don't chase the ball. But the main thing was just keep your balance and don't fall in that water. Once I fell, I had to be like a cat in water and get right up.
I thought you were gonna hit your nuts on that one. Garbrandt 2, Dillashaw 1, Garbrandt serve.
TJ, behind you. TJ!
Yeah! Don't fall, Cody!
Yeah! This game's so hard. So Cody was absolutely demolishing TJ, and he had it up to like a 5-1 lead. And then just when everybody thought it was in the bag and Cody was gonna run away with this thing, TJ starts to get the hang of it.
Cody, yeah!
They went back and forth for the next few games. Until Cody is leading 8-4. He is now 2 points away from winning the challenge.
Let's go! 8-4, it was nice to see the blue team just diminished with no faith in TJ to win this, to pull this out.
I gotta do it, now or never, right? So I'm kinda getting the feel of it, and it's all about the distance.
Yeah? 8-5, Garbrandt serving. Whenever you're ready, Cody.
TJ, look at me.
Smooth, TJ, smooth.
Let's go.
One, when I went under and submerged myself underwater, that was it. I got back up there, and it was different.
8-6, Garbrandt, Dillashaw serving. Whenever you're ready, TJ.
Wind was blowing, I felt it in my ears. Kind of made me lose focus a little bit.
Let's go! Hit it!
Go for the kill!
Let's go!
Yeah! Once my hair was wet and out of place, it was my kryptonite.
It's 8-7, Garbrandt. Garbrandt is serving.
Oh, he's shook. Win! TJ, look at me. Look at me, TJ. Okay.
Let's go!
Tied up. Boom, my team's on my back. They got me. I feel the momentum swing, and so do they.
It's tied up now. 8-8.
He's shook, TJ. You got him shook. Look at him. He's shook.
Once it evened up, I think Ramsey started talking some trash. For some reason, Cody got offended by all these insults. None of them truly made sense, but they were working.
Hey, Uncle Ryan, you're right. Can't do now. Oh, he's on the side.
Uncle what?
Uncle Uriah, he ain't got to do now. Oh, yeah. I'm scared. I'm scared.
I didn't even know like what I was really saying. I was just kind of throwing out there, drinking a couple buds and just talking at the game. Maybe cross the line or two with Cody, but it's funny, I think.
Oh, yeah. He's shook, baby.
Let's go.
He's shook.
Let's go.
There you go.
Feels real good to be in the lead, but it's not over. I have to finish. You know, I can't let this epic comeback be ruined.
Forget it. One more, TJ. One more.
He's shook, baby.
I got this. Staying focused. So I can go smack Ramsey in his mouth and, you know, go celebrate with my team.
Shook.
Let's go. Night run!
TJ, you ready?
One more.
Cody, you ready? Let's go.
Don't reach for it. Let it go. Come on. There we go. Come on, let it come to you. It'll come. Ah, come on, TJ.
It feels real good to beat Cody. You know, I had an epic comeback, 6 points straight.
That's game.
But it feels even better to do it the way I did. You know, I mentally broke him. I watched him give up, you know what I mean? Like, this is gonna be perfect. It's gonna show exactly how I'm gonna do in the fight. I'm gonna keep the pressure on him. I'm gonna break him.
Hard work! Hard work! Hard work! 1, 2, 3, TJ!
think it really was my hair being messed up. It was my kryptonite.
You know, I think TJ owes me a big portion of that 10 G's.
I know.
I was just playing the game.
Hey, no, in our head.
I know. It's always.
Dan, Maddie was doing the same thing.
I got this.
Later.
Ladies, gentlemen, welcome to the Coach's Challenge. This is my favorite part.
Yes.
You get to relax, and all the pressure is on these two.
I'll take it.
So today, we are going to be swimming. Olympic freestyle. This pool is 50 meters.
Oh.
You guys are going to swim more than the length of 8 football fields.
Oh.
You will go back and forth 16 times. You must touch the wall on both sides. The first one to do it wins $10,000, and their team wins $1,500 each. Good luck, guys.
800 meters of swimming for someone who never swam it, that's just hard to finish in itself. That's a hard feat to conquer in itself.
Eat properly, really.
Forget about the race, forget about the guy next to you. I knew for me it was gonna be tough to do, period.
I got some dense bones. I sink to the bottom of the pool. Long distance swimming is not for me.
All right, guys, it's the 800 meter race for the $10,000.
I look over at Eddie and he's in a Olympic diving position and I was like, oh, he definitely knows what he's doing.
Are you guys ready?
Justin came out hot, same way he does in his fights. He comes out, guns blazing.
So hard.
Right out the gate, Justin starts out fast and builds up a lead on the first lap. I think that Eddie is pacing himself, but if Justin keeps going this fast, Eddie is gonna have a very hard time catching up.
Everybody was telling me, pace yourself. I was telling myself, pace myself. I was just planning on staying a little bit ahead of him as long as I could or the whole time.
Every time I look, I can see Justin thrashing and I can see how far he is ahead. I think his feet are there, so I know he's like maybe a full length in front of me. The competitor in me says, hey, you gotta catch up. But then when I go to a pool and go swim, the older people just take their time and they swim for an hour, 2 hours straight. So I kept telling myself, today you're gonna act like the older people in the pool. You're gonna calm down, you're gonna take your time and just breathe.
Lap and a half in, I was struggling already, and you know I knew I had a long ways to go.
Justin clearly did not think this through properly. He's barely a quarter of the way through, and he is completely gassed out.
I realized I probably was not going to win after he was half a pool length ahead of me. The easy thing to do would be to quit, but the challenging thing to do and to think that I could go to sleep at night and lay my head down comfortably would be to not quit.
That was gangster bar.
There you go. Put the best. Go ahead. Give him the medal.
I'm dying.
And the medal and the money.
It was good, man. For two fighters who don't swim, I think we had a good race. And Justin finished the whole damn thing, and he don't even swim. He finished the race off pure guts, so hats off to him. Swimmer caps off to him.
Yep, I did never concede it. I finished the race, but my heart was pounding. I could feel it pounding against the wall when I was sitting there at the end. Had to try to throw up in private a little bit. That was hard work.
We're super pumped. Eddie got 10 stacks, and we got ourselves a bonus here. We got some extra cash. Since Green Team is now down to 7 members because Lauren left, went to Blue Team. We got to divide that extra 1,500 among us, so we got about 1,700 now.
We're a money team, Green Team.
That was awesome, kid, man.
I'm just happy that I'm still alive and I didn't drown, and no lifeguard or my coach Trevor didn't have to jump in and try to save me. That's what I was the most happy about at the end.
We're going to the UNLV Thomas and Mack Center.
Yeah,
how are you at tennis?
Is that where we're going?
I don't know.
Are we going to play tennis? Ah.
Man, I ain't trying to run this hot ass weather, man.
I'm happy I brought some water, 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 water.
We pull up to the UNLV parking lot, and it's actually pretty darn hot outside, and we don't know what's going to happen next.
Oh, it's about to go down. I hope you brought your running shoes today. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the University of Las Vegas track. All right. My favorite part of the season, the Coach's Challenge. You, the fighters, get to kick back, relax, and enjoy yourselves today and cheer on your coaches. So today's challenge is going to be a 5K race.
Oh.
5K is 13 laps around this track.
What?
It's 106 degrees out today.
Got it.
It is going to be brutal. The first coach to complete 13 laps wins $10,000 in cash. Nice little medal here. And each fighter wins $1,500. All right?
Let's go, KT!
So because it's so hot out here, we actually have water guns there, water. This will be the hydration station. It's up to your fighters to keep you guys hydrated.
Y'all better give me some water.
We can hit you up.
Now, we have gear here for you guys for running. Okay. Everything you might need, sunglasses, everything. You guys gear up and let's do it.
I literally had no concerns about the heat or the run. My only nerves and tension was from the competition, me versus Kelvin, because like I said, I'm very competitive and I want to win.
Out of all the we could have did.
I know.
Out of all the damn.
Long distance running is not something I do for my training, but short sprints, 200 meter sprints and 400 meter sprints is something I do implement in my training camps, but not long distance running.
Look at Rob.
Damn, son.
What size are those, bro?
Extra men.
The heat will never beat me, because that's a mind over matter thing, you know. And I make sure I train all year round. I know I'm conditioned. I know I can run. So yeah, it was just a matter of doing it.
First one to finish 13 laps wins. Ready, set.
That pace was too fast, guys.
What if Rob did track and field? We don't know that. We don't know his background.
Everyone in Australia does track and field.
Oh, okay. Well, what do they do in Australia?
They run around all the time, running around everywhere.
The race starts, and then obviously we're pretty close to that point. But yeah, I wanted to put a little bit of a pace on in the first lap.
go, KG!
Establish a bit of a lead and then sustain it through for the rest of the race.
Whitaker's such a good athlete. Look at the legs on that.
Yeah, let's go, Rob.
Come on, Kevin!
Come on.
He's dying.
You got it, KG.
The whole thing, especially with running in the heat, it's just about finding a pace and sticking with it. You know, it's not a sprint.
Can we stop, team?
Rob, you can always take a pit stop for 2 minutes. That's okay.
Let me tell you what you don't want to do. Take a pit stop. And then have to get out there and start running again.
Go, Penny. Go, Penny. Get in front of him, Penny.
As a team, we support each other 100%. Several of the fighters ran with him. It was well over 100 degrees out in the scorching sun on a track.
Come on, KG!
Control your breathing. You got this.
Every lap, it kind of feels like he's kind of pulling apart from me, and my legs are starting to blow up with lactic acid. And I can feel them getting heavy.
Yeah, let's go, Rob.
Woo!
He's not even breathing heavy. He's not even breathing heavy. Yeah. KG's like... Yeah.
When he's pulling apart a little bit, like I'm thinking, like, okay, I'm gonna get a good stride eventually, and he's gonna get tired.
Keep it up! You're doing good.
More water, more for water.
Rob's in his 11th lap, I'm in my 10th lap. And I just pull over to the side of the grass and start throwing up.
Throwing up. Oh, we saw Kelvin throw up a couple times, so I kind of felt bad for Kelvin, but I was super excited for our team and that Rob was able to run so well even in this heat.
I see Kelvin pull up and start to throw up. My job and my goal was just to keep running, keep the same pace, keep moving.
Woo!
Come on, KG!
He caught up. Did he catch up? Oh, no, he got overlapped.
This is the last lap?
Last lap, this is it.
This is it, all right.
Robert wins, he comes around, he's the winner. You guys are gonna have to get out there and pull a Tanya Harding on him.
Yeah.
Oh, he's coming in strong, too.
Oh, now they're running. We've been running all the time.
Put the medal on him and give him his money.
Having the team support me like that was great. You know, I do it for them. Even though we all come from different backgrounds and different groups and fight teams, we're the closest thing to support you can have in here. So you know, for them to back me up and be behind me, it was great.
That was badass, homie. You can run for a big boy.
So Rob won the challenge and I'm super excited because we made a little bit of money from that and I will be able to pay rent for the next couple of months, so that's super exciting.
Last lap,
last one, come on.
Yeah, one more.
Last one, come. Everybody who can run.
Yeah, let's do it.
So Rob finishes the race and at that point, like, I want to quit, you know, that's in my head, like, Rob's done, I don't have to continue going. But the team was with me, and that's really what changed my mind, and that's really what motivated me.
Come on. Go to the last round.
But they're with me 100%, man, and I love it. I love it. Every stride, I feel is getting bigger and bigger towards the end of the race, and they helped me finish strong, which was pretty cool.
Nice job, man. Way to finish. Good job,
Kelvin.
My team came together. We celebrated together. We ran together. And that's ultimately what I wanted, and I got to do it, even by losing.
It's okay, guys. You got this. We got the rest of the fights.
We wanted to beat the blue team more than winning the money. But it doesn't matter now, because they can win this, like, challenge, but we're going to win the semis, and we're going to be all red in the finale anyway, so.
Robert, I'll see you later. Team Whitaker, congrats, you guys. Good job, brother. Stud. Good job. Good job, Kel. You guys are awesome. Great teamwork, man.
Let's go, dude. Let's go, dude.
We've been waiting for this coach's challenge. We're like, when's this coach's challenge? What's it gonna be?
So we knew that we'll go on to the apex. We end up rocking up with the teams. It's a cornhole. I call it cornhole. I don't really know too much about it. But I know it's an American thing.
All right, guys, welcome to the coach's challenge. This is my favorite part of the season when you, the fighters, get to kick back, relax, and all the pressure is on your coaches to win.
Let's go.
Obviously, we are playing cornhole.
Cornhole, backyard, drinking game. I immediately thought Brian had a pretty good chance.
You know, I'm pretty good at a lot of things, but cornhole, I'm shit at. And I'm like, all right, this ain't going to be good. But I'm still competitive. You know, you still got to stay positive. We can do this.
This is how this is going to work. The coaches will alternate tossing bags. Each of them get 4 bags per turn. Every bag that lands on the board counts as 1 point. The bag that makes it all the way in the hole counts as 3 points. However, the points cancel each other out every turn. So, for instance, if they each land 4 bags on the board, no one will get points. So you have to outscore your opponent to get the points. We're playing to 21. The winning coach gets $10,000, and everybody on his team gets $1,500. You guys ready? Let's play the coach's challenge.
Fucking cornhole. The way I grew up, you go to the Boys and Girls Club, and the top kids play everywhere. So whether it was foosball, whether it was caroms, whether it was basketball, and when I seen this, I go, bro, you're fucked. Pressure, the lights, the people, it doesn't affect me. I looked at Hannah and I'm like, you already know, my boy.
Let's go. Oh, nah, all right. Oh! Let's go, let's go, let's go. Nice. Okay.
Let's go, whoa.
Okay.
Both might be better if he kicks it.
Too hard.
Oh, shit. I'll get mine. I'm getting mine. Don't worry. Damn.
Let's go.
No points in this outward.
The game definitely started off slow. The guys kept canceling each other out for the first few turns.
Miss.
Yeah!
We're gonna be here for a minute.
Brian.
Oh, oh, man, that is crazy.
No.
At that point, I was like, oh, my God, this is going to be forever. We're going to be here all day.
You guys are elite athletes, for Christ's sakes. Come on.
We're sitting there, and I'm like, oh, man, no one's scoring any points. It's not looking necessarily good for us. Then Ortega starts scoring points.
Oh, shit! Ortega took a 6-0 lead, and it looked like he was going to win this thing easily. But then Volkanovski started to put points up on the board.
I got a couple, like, I end up getting my eye in. So we didn't start well, but I started bringing it back.
Volk actually ties it up. He comes back with his own points and evens the score.
The momentum was kind of shifting in Volk's favor. Like, maybe Volk had started to figure out, you know, his throw.
Money.
Got up to 6-0, and then he came up 3, and then it was 6-6. I go, there we go. We got ourselves a fight again. Let's go. Then I got 10.
What is with the bounce?
There you go.
Then I hit 14. And then I was just having fun.
That's your shot. Oi. Nice. Big score.
Yes, sir.
Then he came up to 11, and I was like, he's back in the game. Like, all right, let's, like, he gave me a little drive. Follow through. Like boom, from 14 to 20, and then we have one more, and you're fucked.
No pressure. There you go.
You're good. You're good.
Let's get this in.
That's a game.
The last few turns were all Ortega, and he ended up winning easily. With that, he wins $10,000 in cash, and each of his fighters gets $1,500.
I was so far ahead. Even if he did win it, I was going to win the second one. You're going to lose. It's inevitable.
Yeah, man, I'm competitive, no matter what it is. Even if it's cornholing, I ain't good at it. You know, I'm still going to tell myself I can beat whoever is, even if it's a world champ cornholer. But, yeah, cornhole's not my thing.
We'll put you on blast. Can I get 2 G's more? Just, please?
Get what?
Can I just have 2 G's more?
2 G's more?
Just 2,000 more.
Sure.
Okay, so my 10 G's goes 1,500 to all you fighters.
What a real one.
I genuinely do care about every fighter in this house. Because I know what everyone is fighting for. I know what this means to everyone. I'll share it with anyone. I'm the kind of guy that if I have a dime, you have a nickel.
A real one. My God.
You know, Brian splitting the money. He won from the cornhole game. And splitting with Team Volk. That was honestly a very, very kind thing to do. So I definitely gained a lot of respect for Brian for that.
Fuck! Well, at least you got money. I just wanted you boys to get money.
The fact that Ortega did that was a solid effort. So good on him for that.
I'll see the mounds as well. I was nervous. I want to make the boys money. But they made money anyway.
What's up, guys?
Hey.
All right, guys. Welcome to the Coach's Challenge. This is my favorite part of the season. You, the athletes, have no pressure today. You get to kick back, relax, and have fun, and all the pressure is on your coaches. So, obviously, today is axe throwing.
Go, Andy.
Oh, a long time ago, I throw one without any technique, and I was be able to get it.
I've never done this before. It's something completely new.
Oh, no. Zip it. That was a lot.
Yes! Yeah!
3. Three.
It's round 5 and Amanda nails 2 more. So the score is now 24-10. It's come down to Juliana's last 3 throws. The only way for her to win is to get 3 straight bullseyes. But she missed her first throw and that was the end of it.
1, 2, 3. I get it, I got the victory. Very fun, you know, money for everybody, and everybody's happy. So, it was awesome.
Good game, kid.
This sucks.
Good game.
Money in the bank!
Welcome to my favorite part of the season, the Coach's Challenge. 0 pressure on the fighters, all the pressure is on your coaches. Today is going to be Cold Plunge Trivia. Bruce Buffer will host the competition, and the winning coach gets $10,000. The winning team gets $1,500 each.
All right, boys, let's go. All right.
I thought it would be fun this season to put Connor and Michael to the test with a trivia game, but I didn't want to just test them mentally. I wanted to test them physically, too. We decided to bring in a couple of cold plunges to up the ante. So they're going to have to sit in a tub of 39-degree water while they answer a series of questions. And these guys are used to taking ice baths after training, but this is a whole different ball game.
And now, it's bath time!
Q&A about UFC, the UFC history. I am the UFC history. I was confident I was going to get that one.
So now, get ready, contestants, to get it on. Let's go! Let's go.
Good luck, coaches.
This is the moment you've been waiting for. Let the games begin.
Let's go. Give it a smarty, baby. Money time, baby. Let's go.
I shake like a mofo.
You're shaking right now.
No,
you got
to
shake it over here.
I do about minute three.
We got into the ice bath and his jaw was going, it was rattling. He was absolutely shaking in the thing. I thought we were going to have to call an ambulance or something like that. Now, it was cold, in fairness. But it was all right, but I was a bit sore and banged up from the training, so it actually helped me. You know, when I got in, I was like, it wasn't like, at the start, it was actually like, ah, oh, this is nice.
And who did John Jones beat in his UFC debut? Was it A, Daniel Cormier? Was it B, Matt Hamill? Or was it C, Andre Guzman?
C.
C.
And the answer is? Oh, both yeah. Won. Here we go. Tie ball game. Going into question number three. Against whom did Brock Lesnar get his first UFC win?
C.
A.
It is C.
Now yourself. I'm in the UFC since he's in nappies.
MMA trivia ain't my thing.
Edging forward, to whom did Chuck Liddell lose his final UFC career fight to?
B.
A.
The answer is? Rich Franklin. There we go.
UFC fits, baby.
Conor McGregor out in front.
The coaches seem to be handling the cold pretty well.
It's like the jacuzzi on me, yuck.
But in the final round, they get asked questions about each other. A correct answer is worth 2 points now, and it's coming down to the wire. You can see these guys are struggling. These guys have been in there now. It's got to be like 18, 20 minutes, which is absolutely gangster.
What is Chandler's nickname? A, Iron. B, the Terror. C, Skippy.
Skippy!
Skippy.
Should be Skippy. A, Iron.
A, Iron's correct.
Oh.
In which year was Conor named the best UFC newcomer? A, 2000. B, 2013. C, 2023.
2000, right?
I'm tired.
You're like 48.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
He's got
We're
it.
Both in the tub.
The answer is B. Correct, 2013. All right, that's three answers correct for Michael Chandler.
Chandler has managed to tie this thing up at 14 all, and it's come down to Connor's final question. If he gets this right, he wins.
Last one, Connor. How many of Chandler's wins come by way of TKO? A, none. B, 11. What? C, 13.
Yeah, I'll say B.
Okay, it says B.
I'm coming. He's
B is correct. And the winner is Conor McGregor. 20-18. And the rich get richer.
It's tough. Obviously, I didn't want to lose to Conor at anything in any one of these challenges or fights or anything. So losing the coach's challenge was tough, and I really felt like I let my team down. I wanted to be able to hand these guys cash, and I felt like I failed them. But ultimately, yeah, when it comes to Team Chandler versus Team McGregor, we were way up on the scorecards. But it was definitely tough to lose the coach's challenge, but Team Chandler shall prevail.
Got the W, baby. The rich get richer. There's about 10 in this pocket that I'm at the winner. I got 10 in this pocket that I'm at the bringing. And let's see, the roulette on the wrist. The house is always winning, baby. Yeah, I'm in the house.